Thanksgiving is North America's harvest holiday, and it wouldn't be a party without the traditional stuffed turkey. And no one makes stuffing quite like your own mum. And this man loved his mum's stuffing so much, it gave him an idea.
I come from a family, there was 12 of us in the family. So Thanksgiving was a great time to be around. I didn't know it at the time, but I never realized how good the stuffing was. Then I realized later in life that it was Pepperidge Farm.
Okay, Bill, and can you share the secret of your mum's stuffing?
My secret is, put it in the bird and take it out of the bird.
Right, thanks. Anyway, the stuffing is made here at this solar-powered facility in Bloomfield, Connecticut, USA.
Thanksgiving stuffing start right here.
First, a batch of white bread is made by pouring 22 kilos of salt and 20 kilos of their secret seasoning recipe into a mixer. Then 635 kilograms of flour, 17 kilograms of yeast, 360 kilograms of water, and 13 kilograms of canola oil are pumped into the mixer through a maze of pipes overhead. And with the push of a few buttons, giant paddles hidden inside the machine start kneading the dough. We can't see inside the mixer, but Givenson will demonstrate how it works. Impressive. After 15 minutes of kneading, he washes down the exterior of the mixer with oil and pours out the mountain of dough, or pre-stuffing as it's commonly known. The dough is then directed into a huge hopper that produces large portions. The pieces of dough travel along a series of conveyors that drop them into more hoppers that chop them into smaller 450 kilogram pieces. These loaf-sized portions dart along more conveyors into a rounder that flings them about until they emerge as small dough balls. The dough balls continue their journey until they're squeezed flat. They're then pressed beneath a chain link contraption that rolls them into cylinders. Each piece falls into a loaf pan before 2,500 pans come together to move into a proofer. The loaves spend 60 minutes in here, which provides just the right conditions for the yeast to make the dough rise and fill up the pan. Once they've risen, the loaves are on the move again. They travel beneath high-pressure jets of water that slice each loaf open along the center. This helps them attain the right shape as they rise even more when they bake. The loaves keep moving through a continuous tunnel oven that bakes a steady stream of loaves as they enter one end, and 30 minutes later, emerge fully baked at the other. The loaf trip continues until they pass underneath the suction cup roller and are plucked from the pan. They're pulled up onto yet another conveyor, which carries them into a huge cooling room. This room holds 14,000 loaves in its giant rotating stacks. The bread arrives piping hot at 93 degrees Celsius. And after 80 minutes in the room, leaves having cooled to just 32 degrees. At this point, they do something a little unexpected. The baked bread moves out of the cooling room into giant plastic totes, where they spend the next 36 hours aging.
We let it sit. And at Pepperidge Farm, we let it sit for over 24 hours. Others don't.
Right. And the idea is that during those extra hours, the moisture in the bread becomes evenly distributed, and the loaves gradually develop the ideal texture for the next part of the process. Once they've been aged, whole wheat and white loaves get processed together to produce the signature mix that goes into the seasoned herb stuffing. Each tote is placed onto a lift that carries it onto another conveyor. At this point, both whole wheat and white loaves enter the line together. They then travel along the conveyor until they drop into a grinder. Goodbye, loaves. Hello, stuffing. The grinder cuts the bread into crumbs that are just right for stuffing. The breadcrumbs are dropped into compartments and continue along through this dehydrator. When the bread enters the dehydrator, it's 28% water. As it travels through the tunnel, almost all of the water content is removed. By the time it's passed through, the moisture level is only 3%. The breadcrumbs are shaken and drop into a bucket conveyor that lifts them up and carries them to a rotating tunnel. It mixes them thoroughly to obtain a consistent blend of white and whole wheat. crumbs travel into a batch weigher that measures out 400 grams of stuffing and drops it into bags. They make 500,000 bags of stuffing every week, and each bag is heat sealed and then conveyed to the packaging area. The bags of stuffing are packed in stages by hand into master boxes. The filled sealed boxes then head to the warehouse, where they'll be dispatched to Thanksgiving shoppers everywhere.
I'm a big believer you can't eat enough on Thanksgiving.
Me too, Bill. But why limit yourself to Thanksgiving? I love getting stuffed.